Those modifications will get you to around the 320-ish wheel horsepower range, depending on your tuning. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we're talking about performance modifications and upgrades for the Volkswagen Golf GTI Mark 7 and Mark 7.5. Despite coming with only about 220 horsepower from the factory, the Mark 7 GTI can actually produce pretty significant power levels from its 2-liter four-cylinder engine because it comes with a turbocharger. So with proper tuning and basic bolt-on modifications, we can get the Mark 7 and 7.5 GTI up to about 300 to 350 wheel horsepower. Better yet, with some more advanced modifications like fueling upgrades and turbocharger upgrades, these engines are actually capable of handling 500 plus wheel horsepower. So they are extremely strong engines that have a ton of room for performance modifications. Of course, going for those higher power levels is going to come with a way higher price tag and more advanced modifications. For the sake of this video, we're going to talk about these more basic bolt-on modifications that can get you in that 300 to maybe 350 wheel horsepower range. Before we go ahead and jump into that list, let's just go ahead and talk briefly about the power limits that you'll reach on these engines as you start to modify them. So the first limitation on these 2-liter EA888 engines is going to be the stock turbocharger. On your basic 91 or 93 octane fueling, you're going to max out the stock turbocharger around the 300 wheel horsepower mark. If you run something like an E30 blend, we can get about 325 wheel horsepower out of the stock turbo, but that's going to be the maximum without doing any additional fueling modifications. If you do some fueling upgrades and run a higher ethanol blend, you can get maybe closer to about 350 wheel horsepower out of the factory turbocharger, but ultimately that's going to need to get upgraded as well. Going alongside the turbocharger being capped out, somewhere in the 300 plus range, our fueling is also capped out there. So fueling is going to be one of the things on this list that we talk about later. And so I will give a little bit more details there. One of the things that I mentioned earlier was that these engines can handle over 500 wheel horsepower. That is true. The heads, the block, the internals are all extremely strong and can handle those horsepower levels. But on these EA888 engines, torque tends to be the number one limiting factor. Rather than talking about what the horsepower limit of these engines are, it's really more important to talk about what the torque limit is. And 425 wheel torque is about the safe torque levels on these engines. Once you start pushing past those levels is when you start to run into potential internal problems. So hopefully that was helpful. 300, 350 horsepower, these are the list of modifications that you're gonna need. Number one is tuning. Tuning is where all our big power gains are gonna come from, and of course it's gonna serve as the building block for all of the additional modifications that we do afterwards or before, depending on what order you want to do them. But tuning predominantly is gonna make more power by turning up the boost on the factory turbocharger. So a lot of these other modifications will add power, but a lot of it's to help support the fact that the turbocharger is now working a lot harder to compress air to these higher pressure ratios that we're now running. From tuning alone, depending on how aggressive of a tune you get, you can easily get 100 plus wheel horsepower with tuning and the proper fueling for it. With just a basic plug and play tuner too, if you don't want to get too crazy into anything, you can buy something with just basic off the shelf maps. You flash them on there and you get an easy 50 wheel horsepower, safe, reliable. And then to help support tuning, the second modification that I recommend is an upgraded intake system or a cold air intake. What this is gonna do is help bring more air to the turbocharger, which is gonna help reduce stress on the turbo and help improve the efficiency of it. And from that, we are therefore going to create more power. You're not gonna see crazy big gains off of a cold air intake, but it is important to start bringing more air to the turbocharger to compress that air even further. You'll likely see somewhere from around 5 to 10 wheel horsepower gains when combined with tuning. After that, the third thing is gonna be an upgraded downpipe. Now that we have the turbocharger running higher boost levels and we have more air coming into the engine, the third component is getting that air out of the engine more quickly. and the best way to do that is via an upgraded downpipe. The downpipe is the first part of the exhaust system that bolts directly up to the turbocharger, and it's where the catalytic converter is housed. That catalytic converter creates a lot of back pressure, and so that back pressure acts as a force against the turbocharger as it spins. So it ultimately decreases the efficiency of the turbocharger and slows down your turbocharger spool. So by upgrading the downpipe to either a high flow catted downpipe or a completely catless downpipe, we can reduce all of that back pressure, and that's gonna allow the turbocharger to spin a lot more freely. It's gonna spool faster, and all in all, that's gonna help also reduce the amount of heat that the turbocharger is producing, which is beneficial for a reliability standpoint. So a downpipe is gonna be the best exhaust modification that you can do. You get really good power gains out of them, but you're also getting reliability gains out of it too. Fourth modification on our list is gonna be an upgraded intercooler. The intercooler on the Golf GTIs is okay for factory power levels, but once we start talking about turning the boost pressures up, bringing more air in, bringing more air out, there's gonna be a lot more air that the intercooler has to try to now cool down. So the small stock factory intercooler starts to become susceptible to what's called heat soak once we throw on these bolt-on modifications and tuning and are running higher than stock boost levels. What heat soak does is it starts to actually take away from performance. The intercooler can't keep up with the volume of air that's going through it, and so ultimately you end up sending hot air into your engine, which hot air in your engine is not good from a reliability standpoint, but two, it is also bad from a performance standpoint. An intercooler will give you power gains. You're probably looking a little bit closer to the 10 to 15 wheel horsepower level. And so just from a power gain standpoint, an intercooler is definitely worth it, but it's more important for consistent performance. An intercooler is definitely one of the best things that you can do for the overall health of your engine when tuned. It's gonna be the biggest reliability improvement, and it's gonna have your engine running the healthiest and the most efficiently when running higher than stock boost levels. To get above 300, we're gonna need to leverage fueling. When I say that, we're gonna need to start running ethanol blends. The GTI can handle about an E30 blend without needing any fuel pump upgrades. An E30 blend alone will give you 15 to 20 wheel horsepower. So that's what we're gonna need to max out these engines without having to upgrade the fueling or upgrade the turbocharger. So ethanol fueling is the fifth modification on the list, and that's what's really gonna bring this all together and maximize your power gains without getting into these more expensive modifications. And then the one bonus thing that I wanna throw on here is upgrading the diverter valve. The factory diverter valve is plastic, and so it can start leaking boost at higher boost levels. And of course, we need to make sure we're not leaking boost, otherwise we're gonna be losing performance from that. So upgrading the diverter valve to make sure that we're holding all the boost pressure that we're creating is gonna be important for maximizing power as well. And so diverter valve upgrades are good supporting modification that you're not going to see any horsepower out of, but you'll make sure you're not losing horsepower from leaking boost. So those are really the basic bolt-on modifications to cover here. So with E30 fueling and tuning, an intake to bring more air in, an upgraded downpipe to let the air out more quickly, and then an intercooler to make sure the charge air all stays cold. Those modifications will get you to around the 320-ish wheel horsepower range. Depending on your tuning, these are gonna get you a really strong, powerful GTI. But of course, like I mentioned, we can take these things to 500 wheel horsepower and, you know, 425 wheel torque, kind of being right on the safe limit of these things. Ultimately, you know, once we start talking about breaking past, you know, 325 wheel horsepower, we're talking about opening up the bank account a little bit more to get some more expensive modifications. Whether you want to take things a step further or not, it's up to you and the budget that you have, but these things are fantastic with these basic bolt-on modifications that I discussed, so they'll make these things a lot faster and a lot more fun to drive. Anyways, guys, if you appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all our future content, because maybe sometime down the road, we'll go ahead and get into some more advanced modifications for the GTIs and talk about turbocharger setups, fueling upgrades, and more.